Hi everyone, it's Shirley here. So previously I've done a video on how much it cost us, two adults and one dog, to live in Seattle. And since we've been in quarantine now and have been working from home for the last 3 months, I think that mix has changed a little bit. More so, I think we're starting to spend less money on lunches and eating out and more on groceries. Although every time we do go to the grocery store, we're spending $200 to $300 per store. So I don't know how much money we're actually saving there. So without further ado, let's get started. First, let's talk about our mortgage. This hasn't changed at all since we've been in quarantine, so we're still paying about $3,800 a month. But hopefully in the next 2 months or so, we will start to see a little bit of a change there because we managed to refinance our mortgage from 4% to 3.25% at zero closing cost. So I'm very looking forward to that. Now let's take a look at the credit card bill to see how much we spent on general shopping, how much we spent on groceries, on gas, on miscellaneous, etc. Now just a warning ahead of time, this is not going to look pretty because this month we spent a lot to get everything set up for a standing desk, for my work from home station, for some other electronic toys that we probably didn't need. So let's get started. As you can see, much of our expenses from shopping comes from Amazon, and that's partly due to the quarantine. But I had bought a monitor, the Biotech one, that I eventually returned for a more expensive monitor, and that was around $500. And then some sheets and some Costco, which is easily $300, $400 every time we go, as well as, what is this? This is a suit that Mr. Lane had bought for a friend's wedding. And of course, LeetCode subscription, which will yield very high returns for us, hopefully. And additional things like PayPal from Apple, that was a refund for the old iPhone trade-in. Woodcraft, which is our butcher block that I'm using as the tabletop. As well as some Nordstrom and other Apple goods. So the total for the shopping comes down to $2,300 for the last month. Now moving on to groceries. Groceries is more reasonable. The Maruta Shoten is a takeout sushi store, and then there's the usual suspects, the Montlake Market, Metropolitan Mart, Asian grocery store, Safeway, etc. So groceries came to a little bit over $800 last month. Moving on to gas, we did really good in this section because we didn't really go anywhere last month, spending only about $18. And then for bills and utilities, there's internet as well as our Spotify family account. And then professional services, this is where we got the appraisal, and that cost a little bit of money. And of course, our water heater had to break down during the middle of quarantine, so that was an unexpected out-of-pocket expense. We also did some home improvement shopping at Home Depot, and Fully is a standing desk frame that I bought. And good to go is the toll bridge. So this is how our final bill looks like. As you can see, we spent nearly $10,000 last month. I am not happy about this, but I think a lot of it is one-time expenses. For instance, a water heater and the appraisal for refinancing. The shopping and miscellaneous, we bought an Apple Watch and a monitor, which are big expense items. And also we had other things like my standing desk and all of my work from home set up there. So we can definitely save money there going forward. And utilities comes directly out of our bank account, so you don't see it in the credit card statement. Compared to pre-quarantine expenses, I think we definitely removed some categories altogether, like lunch and eating out, as well as the gym and some rideshare activity there. But overall, we did spend significantly more on one-time setups, as well as miscellaneous water heater breakdown and home appraisals.
As much as I would like to think that we spent less money by by being at home and eating at home, in reality, as you can see from here, we spent significantly more. And a lot of it is one-time expenses, including setups, home appraisals to get a lower interest rate, or the water heater breaking, which you really just can't predict. But all in all, it was very insightful for me to understand how much we spent during the first bit of quarantine, and I hope you found it useful. And if you did, I would love a thumbs up and for you to subscribe.